Now let's talk about the female reproductive system. Okay, regarding the female reproductive system, the female reproductive system may look a bit simpler in picture, but its functions are quite complex. However, let's talk about the anatomy first. Okay, so we begin with the gonads, the ovaries. The ovaries are the gonads of the female. There's a left and a right one, just like in the male, there's a left and the right testes. The ovaries are inside the core of the body. Unlike the male ones, the ovaries never descend out of the body. They stay inside the abdomen of the body, or rather around the hip area. Now, what do? The ovaries contain a lot of egg cells, ova. Each ovum is surrounded by many caretaker cells, also known as follicle cells. Each group is known as a follicle. Now, we won't discuss them in detail here, but if you hear mention of them, then you know what they are now. Okay, so the ovaries already contain a lot of ova, but none of the ova are mature yet. It is during each menstrual cycle that a single ovum will continue the maturation process and be released into the fallopian tube or oviduct. So these are what we call the oviducts. These are the tunnels where the ovum will be traveling down. During the menstrual cycle, there is a process called ovulation. The ovum will be released from the ovary and they enter the fallopian tube or oviduct here. So how do we spell fallopian tube? That's the alternate name of the oviduct. I'll write that here. Okay. So what's the fallopian tube like? It's a tunnel. It looks smooth in this picture, but it's actually not. The inner lining of the fallopian tube contains a lot of cilia, that's finger-like projections. And you can see it in the notes over here. This is mentioned. The finger-like projections called cilia. So they are not shown in the picture, but they are there. They will be what moves the ovum. If you can remember, the ovum has no tail, the ovum cannot move on its own. So it relies on outside forces to move it. The ovum doesn't last very long. When the ovum is released, it will only survive for approximately 1 to 2 days. But the journey from the ovary into the uterus over here may take more than 2 days. Maybe 1 week or more. And this means that the ovum will almost certainly die before it reaches the uterus. Therefore, if fertilization is to occur between the sperm cells and the ovum, fertilization must occur in the fallopian tube. Okay? Then, whether there is or no fertilization, the ovum will travel down all the way into the uterus. Now this large structure is the uterus. The uterus is a very muscular organ. The inner lining is special. It's called the uterine lining. The uterine lining is very responsive to estrogen and progesterone hormones. Every menstrual cycle, whenever the estrogen levels or progesterone levels rise, the uterine lining becomes thicker. And by thicker, I mean that the blood vessels within the uterine lining proliferate. They have much more blood vessels, so that they can receive a fertilized egg cell, which will implant in it. If a fertilized egg cell implants in the uterus, it can implant anywhere along the uterine lining. And if it's successful, it will start to develop into a fetus. Okay, the uterine lining, however, will break down if there is no fertilization at the end of every menstrual cycle. Now, if it breaks down, the contents will pass through this region. So what is inside this region? We're going to take a closer look. Now, here below the uterus is a structure called cervix. Think of the cervix as sort of like a doorway. Now the cervix is here in this region, in my picture over here. Let me erase that a bit. In my picture on the left side here, this is the cervix. The cervix guards the opening into the uterus from the outside. Outside the cervix, below is the vagina, here, this region over here. The vagina is where, during sexual intercourse, the male's penis will be inserted. During sexual intercourse, ejaculation will occur, and then the semen that is released will be released into the vagina. Sperm cells will swim through the cervix if the cervix is open. Remember, the cervix is like a doorway. Most of the time, the cervix is closed, or at least very, very closed with a very tiny opening. However, during certain times of the menstrual cycle, we call the fertile period, the cervix will open up so that sperm cells can more easily enter for the purposes of fertilizing the ovum. Okay? Now, the cervix and the vagina also constitute the birth canal. So what is the birth canal? The birth canal is the path through which the baby is born. So imagine if there were a pregnancy and a fetus were to develop within the uterus. For it to be born, it will exit through the cervix and through the vagina. During that process, the cervix will dilate, meaning that it will become much bigger so that the baby can go through it. Okay? There are some cases where, for whatever reason, this cannot be done. Perhaps the hip bone of the mother is too small, or due to some medical complication, it cannot be done. In that case, the baby can be delivered through a cut over the abdomen, over the uterus. That will be called cesarean section, also known as C-section. Okay? Right. So, again, with the left side, we have a frontal view. On the right side, we have a side view of the anatomy. You need to familiarize yourself with both views, because just like with the male reproductive system, you may be tested on both. Okay?